Brother Daniel. Thank you, sister, for the playing. Good evening, everybody. How many of you are tired? Everybody's tired, right? I'm tired. I had a long day. I did two jobs in the morning, praise God. And then they took me out two tooth. Man, pretty soon I'm going to need a brand new license plate. But in heaven, I'm not going to need none of that. Open your Bibles this evening to the book of Proverbs. Knowledge. Who wrote the book of Proverbs? Brother Kenny? Who wrote the book of Proverbs?
Solomon.
Solomon had a lot of women, right? Man. One time I was preaching a message in the county jail, Brother Jaime, and I was illustrating the life of Solomon. And one of the inmates said, "You know what, Brother Jaime, I wish I could be Solomon too. Have plenty of women, just get out of here and get me out of this jail." But the good news that he received Christ on his heart. Friday, I had the opportunity to be in the federal prison. Two guards got saved and an inmate. Sunday morning, give thanks to Brother Garza for helping me out early morning. We went over there to the rehab center. And I guess there were two souls that got saved. Tuesday morning, yesterday morning, I went to the county jail, Sister Liz, and 12 inmates and one guard. Now they're changing the rules there, so pray for me. Every time you go to jail, I got to have two guards, one on the right, one on the left. Now they don't want me to go inside the jails no more. You know, they shut the jails. And from there, I'm going to be, I can't even be touching those bars. Just the word of God. Got to keep at least a yard. These are new regulations in the Hidalgo County Jail. And right now, that's the only rules. Federal prison, I'm allowed to go in there and preach God's word. The title of tonight's message is Be Wise in the Lord. Spanish, ser sabios con Dios. Be wise in the Lord. Proverbs 3, I'm going to start reading a verse 3. Proverbs 3, verse 3. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. Write them upon the table. The table. Bind in the table of them. Write them upon the table of the dying heart. Verse 4. So shall thou find favor and good understanding in the sight of God and men. Verse 5. This is going to be the main event. Verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all thy thine heart and lean not into the thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him. And he shall direct thy path. I like that verse. One more time. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. 7. Be not wise in in your own eyes. Telling us, be not wise on yourself. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. Brother Jaime Reyes, this message is for me. I deal with a lot of folks every day, every minute, every second, Brother Jaime, in pest control. So I try to do my job. That's it. Get my money and run. Get out of there. Vámonos. Be not wise in your own thine eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. Verse 8. It shall be health to thy navel and marrow to thy bones. 9, honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruit of all thine increase. substance and with the first fruits of all the time increase. There's three things important. I'm not used to wearing glasses or not. I'm wearing glasses now and I see the big letters and get me a little bit out of hand. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we give you thanks, Lord, for the day, for the work, for everything, Lord, that getting here to the middle of the week, Wednesday night. Lord, take control of the service. Continue blessing our pastor, Brother Will, and all of us that are here. If there's somebody here tonight, Lord, that is not saved, save him before it's too late. Lord, we love you, and we ask it in Jesus' name. There's three things important that's going to help us on this side of eternity where we're alive. First of all, trust. Second, the direction. We need a direction. And thirdly, fear the Lord. How many of us fear the Lord? One hand, two hands, three hands. Oh, man. I fear God. Those weepings are, he is real. He is real. Solomon here tells us in verse number 5, trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not into thine own understanding. He's trying to tell us, hey, never do your things your way. If you're a follower of Christ, if you're a believer of Christ, because it's not going to work. Sometimes I travel the valley and I get lost. And I get so very impatient because I don't know how to work with the phones, directions, Brother James. This way, this side. So I call Martha, hey, help me out. But I get so that I can't find these places. So what I do, I park the truck and I ask for the best help. Help me, Lord. I'm lost. I can't do it with your help, Lord. Solomon is trying to encourage us. You'll never make it by yourself. Verse 5, trust in the Lord. That's the first thing. Trust in the Lord with all thy what? Heart. And lean not into the thine own understanding. I remember when I was in Bible college, Dr. McQueen was very, 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 very sharp in it. You know Brother McQueen. He said, guys, I'm not going to be forever here. What I'm teaching you, hide it in your heart. God gave you a brains. Use it. And he's so true. This is what Solomon is trying to tell us. God gave us a brain. Use it. But for a reason. To honor him. Right? Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Very simple. And I was a president there in Bible college. I didn't even know what president was, but they chose me. I think we were about 10 or 12 in Bible college over there in Chinese Light Ministry. But it was a blessing. It was a blessing because we learned a lot through the Word of God. And most of the things that I learned, you know, when you get to a certain age, it's hard to grab everything, but this is what our teacher told us. If you try to get something and hide it in your heart, it will be a blessing. That's what Solomon is trying to tell each and every one of us. Solomon had everything in life. He had women to cut the nails, to paint him, and, you know, he had everything. Solomon. Over 1,000 women, about 1,000 women. But Solomon came to a finish line, Brother Jaime. Came to a finish line. He said, you know what? Vanity over vanity over vanity. Trying to tell us there's nothing better than to serve a great God. Trust in the Lord with all our heart. That is the first thing I'm going to get across right now. Trust him in verse 5. Trust the Lord with all the thine hearts and lean not into the thine own understanding. While that doctor put me over there and that get me those tools out, he said, Jaime's going to be kind of rough because those, they got roots. And the only thing I felt was those, you know, he was trying to drag it out, and I was just so calm. Dear Jesus, help me, Lord. You know, we get to the point that in an age time, everything is going to fall apart. Everything is going to collapse. Not even the plastic surgery is going to help you. Solomon is trying to tell us here, trust on the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and all your understanding. The second thing, a direction. We need a direction in life. Versículo 6. In all thy ways, acknowledge him. Trying to tell us, put God first in every direction we go in this life. Because it's not getting easier. We're getting old. Just look at the days. Holidays coming, Christmas right away. Seems to me it was yesterday. Now it's Christmas. Go to those stores, lights and everything. Brother, amen. You know, the days are going so fast, so fast. I don't remember the day I called my wife and said, you know what, amen? Jesus is coming. And I'm more sure that we're living the last days. The last days. In all our ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. What do we have to do? We have to acknowledge the Lord Jesus Christ every minute, every second. We're only a breath away. Man, this body of mine has had more surgeries than I don't know. Now the tools, now what it is, probably going to build me a robot still walking here, breathing on this side of eternity. I don't know. A guy said, Jaime, you're in bad shape. You're supposed to listen to the doctors. Like when they were giving me chemo, I was supposed to rinse out every day, mouthwash. And sometimes for being in a rush and a hurry in my job, I forget it. I'm one of those. This is what occurs. Now I'm suffering the consequence. Pull everything out. Just let my mind be directly into him. Am I telling the truth? Our mind is supposed to be directly into the Lord. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. What is path? In front, he's going to direct you. That's it. I travel from right to left, from front to back, Westlaco, Mercedes, Edinburgh, Mission, Palm View. And I say, Lord, you just direct my path to continue going forward, do my job, and share the gospel. People need the Lord out there. People need the Lord. First thing is trust in the Lord. Second thing is direction. But let me get your attention there in that verse. What was it? 3:3. Proverbs 3:3. It got my attention right now that I was with my wife. It says, let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. You know what I understood about that word? You know what the word bind means? It means tie. And I say, how are you going to tie it in your neck? Get everything tied up with the word of God. That's what he's trying to tell us. I've seen preachers that bind devils and Satan. Solomon is telling us over here, bind it where? In the neck. That's an important word for all of us. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. Bind them about thy neck. Write them upon the table of thine heart. In your heart, we're supposed to hide them. And this message I apply for me every day. If I hear something in that 91.5 that is going to be a blessing, I try my best to hide it in my mind, my heart. So the first thing we got to do is what? Trust and obey. Second thing, we need the direction. And that the direction is, it only comes from who? From the Lord above. And the third thing, fear God. Verse 7, fear God. Be not wise. Ay, ay, ay. Look at that word. Be not wise in thy own eyes. Trying to tell me, Jaime, do not be wise in your own sight. Don't think me too smarty man, because you'll never make it without me. See, you know, be not wise in thy own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. What is evil? There are three things that we're going to have a problem in life. Our own flesh, the desires of the flesh. Second, the world. The world is going to suck you like a vacuum cleaner inside. And the third is the devil. This world, every direction you turn, it's like a vacuum cleaner. Fear the Lord. Fear the Lord. That is in verse, honor the Lord with all thy, in verse 7, be not wise in your own sight, fear the Lord, and depart from evil. You know, in the days that we're living right now, evil is so real. Every time I go to jail, I say, Lord, help me, Lord. Protect me. Only one soul I'm asking. That's all. One soul, Lord. But if you have more souls in that county jail, that federal prison, that rehab center, you save them, Lord. Use me. Because I'm no good for nothing, Lord. Help me out. I need your help. I'm trying to encourage each and every one of our members here in our church on the book of Proverbs. I love the book of Proverbs. I love the book of John. And I love the book of Revelations. Trust, direction, and fear God. Verse 9, honor the Lord with all thy substance and with the first fruits of all thine increase. Who gives us all the blessings? The Lord. For a reason and for a purpose. To be a blessing to others. Nothing belongs to us, Brother Jaime. Many times a man says, well, I'm the man, I pay the bills. Jaime Reyes, you don't pay nothing. God gives you the strength. God gives you everything to live on this side of this world. I wish I could turn the clock back and start carrying Jessica again. I can't do that. No more. She's a grown-up lady. I mean, the days are passing right away. You wish you could turn the clock and, I'm going to carry Jessica one more time. Can't do that. I can't stop that clock. We're leaving, we're leaving, we're leaving, we're leaving, we're leaving, we're leaving every day, every day, every day, every day, every day. Solomon came to the finish line. Everything is what? Vanity. They can stretch that face, plastic surgery, do everything, you still. That's it. That's what my doctor was telling me today. Jaime, a long time ago, Jaime, we were working over there in Plainview, Texas, Tulia, Texas, years ago. How the time changes, Jaime. Your tooth are coming out. Man. They go, you know what? Doctor, I'm still preaching God's word. Go for it, Brother Jaime. Continue praying for my family too. In 3 more months, I'm going to go and see that doctor again. If I'm alive. But if I'm gone, I'm going to be in a better place. No more cancer. No more headaches. No more worries. No more paying bills. Nothing. I've known a lot of people who's got a lot of money on this side of eternity. And they're not happy, Brother James. You know why they're not happy? Because they don't have Jesus in their heart. The main thing, the main event, having Jesus in our heart. Be not wise in thy own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. And he shall direct your path. I love it. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not into your own time understanding. I can comprehend that without God, we can do nothing. John 15, without God, we cannot do nothing. Nada. He owns us. He brought us into this world. I had an inmate Tuesday step forward. He said, Brother Reyes, pray for me. My daughter is very sick, and they don't give me no chance to go and see my daughter or anything. I go, well, the only thing I can do is just pray. His daughter is very sick at home. And he was worried there in jail. I guess he was there messed up, DWI, second time. And he's going to be serving, I guess, 3 to 4 years, state prison. He said, I'm safe. I received Christ. And I know my mistakes. I know, and I know what I'm headed. I deserve it. I don't listen. Solomon is trying to tell us, this world cannot offer you what the Lord offers us. And Solomon had it made. He had money to burn, women. But he came to the end. It's nothing better than serving a great God. And that is my message for tonight, Wednesday night. Try to encourage all of us to continue praying for one another, praying for our pastor, praying for our members. Very important. A lot of killing going on out there. That's why every time I go and preach in that county jail, I have 2 guards, one on this side, one on this side. I'm not allowed to even shake their hands. Not even if he's my brother in blood. No shaking hands. Don't give them any gum. Don't give them any piece of tracks. Don't give them anything. Just share the gospel. These guys point a beautiful face inside the jail. And another day, only God knows their heart. Only God knows their heart. Have I been incarcerated? Yes, I have. I go in there and I preach for a long time. And I enjoy it. I love what I do it, serving a great God. Sunday, I was so tired. I saw Brother Garza there standing in the driveway. Brother Garza is here, man. Get up in the truck and say, Lord, help me and Brother Garza, Lord. Direct us there. Save souls, Lord. Give him the power. Give him everything that he might preach. 2 souls got saved. We had a real good breakfast. Scrambled eggs, potato and beans, hot chili. Thank you, Lord, for the food. Let's go over there. Let's go and preach. We got to be there at 8:30. By 9:30, we got to be out of there. 9:20. Cut it. Vámonos. Let's go. They take that group, put them back in their bunks. Trying to be a blessing to those people over there. So I encourage all of you, continue praying for me. Because I'm not turning back. I'm going to continue going forward until he calls me home. I want to see everybody over there on the other side. Amen. Trust in the Lord. We need his direction. And the third thing, fear God. Very important for all of us. We got to fear God. Because those weepings hurt. Man alive. He loves you. For God so loved the what? The whole world. That he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have what? Everlasting life. One day Brother Jaime, I don't know, going to be laying in a coffin there. Martha's going to be crying. Probably get up from that coffin and don't cry for me. I'm in a better place. See or no? Or if the rapture comes, vámonos. Vámonos. He's going to be laying there. He's dead. He was a good man. I don't think so. The Bible tells us that nobody's good, for all of us are sinners. All of us. There's not even one person on this side of eternity says, I'm good, but lo and behold, you're a sinner. I was talking to a lawyer there Tuesday. He said, Brother Jaime, I was hearing your interjection. You were telling these people that they're no good. It was the Bible tells it. Like it is written, there's not even one good. He said it, that's it. I take the book, I preach to them, that's it. He said, Mr. Reyes, I'm a good lawyer. He said, go back to college and study. Study the book. Well, Jaime, I make the money. Without God, you cannot make the money, son. So you know, he gives you every breath. God's got the remote control, son. Hey, bingo, boom, you're gone. I say, what's this guy talking about? Who gives us everything? He's God. He said, nah, you crazy preacher. Okay. I don't care. Everybody tells me crazy. I love Jesus. And I'm telling the truth. If you know the truth will set you free. That's it. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we give you thanks, Lord, for being so good to us, Lord, for keeping us alive, sharing your good news. We love you, Lord, and you know everybody's heart here this evening, Lord. Everybody's got petitions. Everybody's got problems. We got problems. Who do we go? You're the only one, Lord, that knows everything about us, Lord. You brought us into the world, and surely you're going to take us back. You help us continue going forward, preaching and teaching your word, Lord. You continue blessing our pastor, Brother Will, and all the people that are working right now with there in Awana, Lord. You help them. Teach that those kids might grow up sooner or later, Lord, on this world, that they might not depart from your word. Lord, we love you, and we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's start picking up.